The John LeBanks Show has been known to make people laugh, sing, think, scream, throw things in rage, and generally lose their minds. Listener discretion is advised. Welcome. Thank you for tuning in. You know who I am. And if you don't, just hang around. There'll be some images down here and it'll tell you who I am. If you're listening in on one of the many affiliate radio stations, thank you for tuning in as well. We got lots to cover this 30 minutes of the broadcast, including stuff around what's going on in Russia and the Ukraine. We've got some Ebola information. Also, Joe Petto's been in the news, of course, because he's always in the news. We've got stuff happening all the way out in with the Facebook land we'll have to talk about. But I think we're going to begin with all you coders out there. I'm sure you've been eager to hear what I've had to say, and probably not. I don't know. But it is 4-4 Easter Sunday, or Ishtar if you go far enough back into history. The Pope had his little mass on the Sabbath, because Sabbath is Saturday and not Sunday. Christians get that stuff wrong sometimes because they're being taught one thing. But from the Associated Press, the Pope urges hope amid darkness. What is that all about? What darkness are we talking about? Well, the darkness of the boogie-woogie virus, apparently. Pope Francis urged his boogie-woogie virus weary flock to not lose hope. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. Given the current conditions and the dark months ahead of us. Dark months. We went from dark winter to now dark months as proclaimed by Pope Francis. So, the mass that was to commemorate the rebirth of you-know-who, that Jesus fella, just happened to be the same day of the 4-4 we were talking about in the coding. And 4-4, well, is it possible that the 8 is born today? Well, we've moved from dark winter, which was brought upon us by the Joe Petto administration and the Orange Man administration, to what's being proclaimed by the Pope as the dark months ahead of us. So is the Pope signaling something or a change? Well, let's go over something. We know the word dark. We're not going to even focus on that. But winter is especially interesting because in the coding, ladies and gentlemen, it is 6 letters long. The letters code out to 23, 9, 14, 25, 8, which equals 89. 8, 9 equals 17. 1, 7 equals your 8 that we've been talking about. Interestingly enough, now that we have gone from the dark winter into dark months, that is also 6 letters. The numbers equal out to 13, 15, 14, 20, 8, 9. Which just happens to equal 89. 8, 9. 8 plus 9 is 17. 7 plus 1 is 8. All of a sudden, we have another 8 there, ladies and gentlemen. Interestingly enough, also something else that is interesting, the date, April 4th, 2021. Well, that equates to 4, which is 8, 2, which is 10, 2, which is 12, 1. 13. But let's go a little further for all you people that are now involved in the tinfoil hat syndrome. The day before 4-4 was April 3rd, 21, or 4-3-2-1. a countdown of sorts, believe it or not. And if you don't believe me, that's okay, because we have the malpractice media doing articles on the 4-3-2-1, the countdown, the date, as they are talking about, that have brought people together. Marriages of sorts. 4-3-2-1. What were we talking about ever since the 1221, the 2-1 code? Is that 13 and 31 were going to join together, merge, make a marriage of sorts. And we just had the countdown, 4-3-2-1 to 4-4, which equals 4-4-2-0-2-1, or 13. Interestingly enough, and the Pope then just goes ahead and tells us that we're going to have dark months ahead, going from dark winter to dark months, all coding out the exact same way to the 8 that we've been talking about the 4-4. Isn't that a coinkydinks of utter epic proportions? I mean, who thought that would ever come to fruition? That these numbers would all just kind of, you know, because we don't believe in that stuff here. Just randomly, we tried to prove some things wrong a year ago, which happens to coincide with one of our best months of the year, which is April. A year ago, we were trying to debunk the people who were talking about the podium situation. And we stumbled across the code in trying to debunk that, and we found out that not only did we not debunk it, we actually proved it was correct. We followed the code, and that's how we eventually came to that 2-1 code that we've been talking about since, I don't know, May, April of last year. And now, as we've told you all along how the code has been changing, here we are with more evidence that somehow the numbers are equaling out to the things I was telling you. I don't know how that happens. I mean, because I'm an idiot, right? I'm just a stupid guy that doesn't know anything. What else do we have in the news, ladies and gentlemen, now that we've gotten past that? Because I just wanted to cover that real quick. We have major concerns with military tension between Russia and the Ukraine. All of a sudden, after Joe Petto takes office, we didn't have this problem when Orange Man was there. Did we? In fact, if you look at it, Orange Man got the Russians to help out with taking out that pesky ISIS group that was hanging around in Syria. And we were actually drawing down what we were doing in Syria. All of a sudden now, with Joe Petto, we're going back to what we were doing in Syria. Russia's now making aggressive moves in Ukraine. And we're seeing that Taiwan and Hong Kong and some other places, the Chinese are, you know, expanding their influence, we'll say. So this, they're calling this a frozen conflict, and what that really means is we're in the early stages of what could turn into something bigger, a cold war of sorts. But there hasn't been a cold war, as you will see with the two articles we made available on the Daily Brew. There's little things, little skirmishes happening in that region. And Russia is building up military forces. All of a sudden, right? All of a sudden. See, it happened during President Zero as well. Remember, before President Zero, the Ukraine had its little thing there. And Russia didn't push through. They may have made threats, but as soon as President Zero got in there and Joe Petto was making those threats to the government of Ukraine, that they better fire that prosecutor so his son doesn't get in any trouble, or the company that his son's working for. I'm sorry. You know, you misspeak, you get in trouble. The whole bunch of that, the Blue Flary crime family. We got to talk about that more often. So, President Zero allowed Russia to annex a part of Ukraine. And it was okay. At the same time, Joe Petto was threatening the Ukraine to fire prosecutors who could, you know, take down either corporations or individuals that are either tied to or related to Joe Petto or Joe Petto's son. That stuff was coming coming clean during Orange Man's administration, we were starting to find out some stuff going on there, right? And how the influence from the President Zero administration, as well as now the certain influence of the Joe Petto administration, which is either mirroring the President Zero agenda or is expanding on it at this point. In fact, it's lightning speed. We're driving down the road in an Indy car, and the brakes are out. So at this point, either the Hippocrat leadership is weak on the old Ruskies there, or the Ruskies are actual allies of the Hippocrats, and the Hippocrats make deals behind, you know, we're going to blame our bad election that you guys did it. Mm-hmm. And we're going to say the Trumpster. Oh, I'm sorry, Orange Man. We're going to say Orange Man was colluding with you, and you're just going to go along with it, do your little thing, you know. Acting like they're at odds, when really they were pretty much working together. Because look, now we have a Hippocrat administration, and the Russians are doing their thing, and the Chinese are going to do their thing too. But there's no influence over our political leadership at this time by those two foreign governments, is there? Now that Orange Man's gone, we're all back to normal. Well, the government is. Us little people still got to wear masks and radical burqa. We got to have restrictions. What about the dude who, the one guy who got the poker and then he gets COVID? Or I mean the boogie woogie. I might have upset Uncle Al Gore with that one. It's a shame. It really is a shame. I don't want to upset Uncle Al Gore. Because he gets mad, and then he puts disclaimers on your videos, and then you get little things blocking your videos and views, and that's already tough enough with the shadow banning that's going on, you know? So, here we are, with a couple of minutes left in this segment. We have Joe Petto administration absolutely letting everybody in at this moment. Come on in. You're the next contestant on being American through amnesty. Know what I mean, folks? Mm-hmm. Come on, man. We've got that. But he's soft on the Ruskies and he's soft on the Chinese. Chinese and the Russians are doing whatever they want. They're building up forces. They're showing that they're about ready to do something. And wouldn't it be just great during the Joe Petto administration? Probably the weakest 13 we've ever had. He's on the level of Jimmy Carter weak. That's why they're going to work to get rid of him real soon. Move him out. You know, he's got the dementia. He's losing it upstairs, folks. We got to use the 25th Amendment or he's going to resign. I don't know. Because I don't think they're going to expose that crime syndicate that he's got. I don't think they're going to do that. Because that would be another way to get rid of him if he didn't just step down, right? Joe, here's the talk. You know, it's the mafia talk, the hypocrites. Listen, Joe, we need you to step down as a 13, do you know? Because we want Deep Throat. You know, we got more influence on Deep Throat than you see. So we want you to step down. And if you don't step down, Joe Petto, we're going to take you out one way or another. Yeah. Because we've got the goods on you. And it would be no problem to, you know, take you out. That's right. That's right. All right, folks, we're going to take a quick timeout as we're already halfway through this broadcast. On the other side, we're going to talk Ebola and Facebook and a bunch of other things that will definitely keep you interested. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Hey, Uncle Shady, where are they going?
Hey, you, get back here.
The Jungle Bank Show will be right back.
Are you in need of commercial or residential window cleaning? Do you need your office clean? Maybe custodial work. How about some gutter cleaning? If you do, then call Pain in the Glass. For a beautiful shine that's crystal clear, call Pain in the Glass. You can find them on Facebook at Pain and the Glass. You're listening to the Joan LeBanc Show.
It's better than an iRater convention.
Welcome back, my friends. Thank you for stopping in. If you're just catching the broadcast as it's live streaming, well, thank you for tuning in. Make sure you go back and check out the first segment. I was a little bit cooking there and talking about the things that we probably will get to a little bit later in this segment, but I wanted to get to some of the news on the possible Ebola crisis or growing crisis that might be happening here in the States. Yeah, you know what's going on in South Africa, right? And I know Monty Pants and some others have talked about this, but apparently Ebola outbreak possible in Washington and Oregon as 27 people between those two states, 23 in Washington. Remember the podium? We talked about that, how Washington was focused on, not Washington, D.C., but Washington. Keep that in mind. Washington, 23 in Washington, who recently traveled from West Africa, are being monitored. These individuals have just returned from New Guinea and the Democratic Republic of the Congo, which are currently experiencing outbreaks, and I'm talking massive outbreaks. People are just up and dying. I think the death rate, and don't quote me on this, but it's above 40% of the people getting it. It's not the boogie woogie where you get like 1% is going to get, you know, because you're already weak, right? It's not that. It's a very high number. So, I have a question. Why aren't we canceling all flights to these countries, if not to all of Africa, for a little while? Is that some form of bigotry? I you know, because in this new world, I'm not exactly sure what is formally bigotry. You know what I mean? Because the term has been expanded upon a little bit, and it covers a wider, you know, it's more of a rainbow, so to speak. Also on the Ebola front, 15 in Kentucky are being monitored for possible travel related and exposure to the Ebola. Yeah, that's right. The governor says the state has connected with most of the travelers and none of them are showing any symptoms at this time. He says that 15 are considered low risk, but we're going to have to monitor these situations. Okay. So the boogie-woogie shuts us down. The boogie-woogie makes us wear masks and all these other, I mean, you heard about the dude who got the poker and then he ended up getting the boogie-woogie. Something, you know, whatever. The medical field's a little wacky right now. The medical monarchy has decided that they're going to decide what's the specific boogie woogies, the specific bugs, the specific illnesses that they're gonna have everybody focus on, even though there are other things, even though they call them low risk. I would say 1% of death is considered low risk when you got about 40 or higher percent of death with this other thing. But you know, whatever. So we have that. We also have that a couple of these capital coppers over there are trying to sue the orange man for physical and emotional injuries from the supposed riot. Why don't they sue the sergeant at arms or even Wicked Witch of the West or Mudface? Because apparently those people were in charge and somebody told others to let all the Trumpsters in. In other news, why Americans could be paying for President Joe Petto's infrastructure plan long after the roads are built. That's because we're talking about taxes and spend and tax and tax and spend and spend. I mean, we could get borrow and spend, but we're going to get borrow, tax, and spend. I guess that's more fair because all the trillions of dollars that have ran through the federal government and we still have infrastructure problems. Where did that money go? Well, I can tell you where it's going. It's going to India and to China and to Palestine and to Israel and to every other country but yours, ladies and gentlemen. That money that you've spent that they are now going to have to borrow or tax you more for because you haven't already paid for those roads, right? You haven't spent enough on the roads at all. They're now going to, well, they're going to come up and borrow some money because they don't have money for the roads, and they're going to find ways to tax people more because they don't have money for the roads. Although they give $1 billion here and $1 million here and $32 million there and everywhere else gets the money except the people or the, well, the people. First thing on the agenda, ladies and gentlemen, in my opinion, I mean, our tax money should go to the roads and the infrastructure. I mean, that should be first. And from what we've been paying over the past 50 plus years, ladies and gentlemen, we should have gold-lined streets. That's right. We should be driving on the yellow brick road. That's what I want, the yellow brick road, for what we've been paying for the infrastructure, or, well, we haven't paid for the infrastructure. We've been taxed for it. We've been told it was supposed to go for it. Remember all these lotteries and everything? It goes for the schools and the roads. Yeah, but nothing ever gets done, or it's always too bad, or what's even better is they just get the roads are just good enough so they'll decay so we can keep all the union workers working. Job security, folks, because the American taxpayer is going to pay for it. That's right. And now we're going to pay for everything because if we're going to let these people in at the border and everything, and then we're just going to let them go and say, go ahead, go to a state that'll let you just get a driver's license and they'll sign you up to vote. And then you can vote with the rest of the socialists for more taxes and for more benefits and for more destruction of freedom. And bringing in the socialist agenda. That's what they want. That's what we're going to get. And good luck with that, ladies and gentlemen. Let's see what else. Facebook. This one is a good one. Facebook data on more than 500 million, that's right, 500 million accounts found online. Just randomly, some hacker put it's all online. It's a couple years old, but that even is more worrisome that it took them that long to find it, don't you think? So you don't know if your data's been revealed from a couple years ago. Maybe in those 2 years you've changed how you've done your internet stuff to protect yourself more, but that doesn't matter because that information prior to that, you maybe not have been so savvy enough to understand the connectivity of the internet. That takes away all privacy, right? Well, you may have changed your behavior, but that doesn't matter because everything before that could have been grabbed up in these 500 million accounts. I'm sure that makes you feel safe, folks. And if you bought any ads on Facebook in that time or if you spent any money through them, because I think there's other ways to spend money through the Facebook there. Well, all that is possibly out in this, and are they telling us who got affected? Did they? I don't know. Do we get a phone call, an email, a little chat message? Are you going to use Messenger? You going to tell us who was affected in these 500 million accounts? You know that ain't going to happen. None of these people are accountable. I guess Mark got hacked too. His public account, I'm sure he has to have his credit card information on his public account on there, right? I'm sure he leaves that on there. What, he's got to buy an ad every once in a while. I'm sure Facebook isn't going to give him a free ad. I mean, that would be terrible, right? He has to pay full price, doesn't he? No employee discount or anything, I'm sure. Absolutely. Absolutely ridiculous. And there's so much more in the news because we could go to the Sludge Report and it's loaded. Sludge Report is absolutely loaded, including robot artists selling art for 688-888. Do you get it? 688-888. Now seeing music. Now eyeing a music career. Did you hear that? Robot. Robot artist is making money. More money than I'm ever going to make. Unless I hit some kind of luckiness there. Why is this a thing? And why are people spending money on a robot artist? Have we lost our minds? Are we just so lost in what really is meaningful and what isn't anymore? Or is it all a fad? Oh, I got the first robot artist. I paid 688-888-888. Because that first robot artist is so cool. He's like the Rembrandt of robot artistry. We're a bunch of fools. And they've got us so bought into this whole gobbledygook system that's way past the time that we can save ourselves from it. And the ones who don't want to be, you know, participating in it, the ones who want to remain holy from it, well, you're going to have a hard time. Because they're encroaching on everything. We haven't even talked about the gun legislation that's been bantied about through all these little random, you know, the random shootings and the events. And we had just had a guy drive up to the gate. They didn't tell you he was an Islamist, right? Again, we had selective reporting from the malpractice media. See, if it was a Trumpster or a Proud Boy or a Oath Keeper or something like that, well, that would have made headline news. Oh, they're trying to take out President Joe Peddle. Uh-huh. But since it was an Islamist who literally just hates the country and hates the Western world, even though he's here, you know, everybody who doesn't like this country, can't you guys go somewhere else? There's plenty of places. Go to Africa. Go wherever you want to go. Why do so many people who dislike this country stay here? Can you explain that to me, folks? I can tell you why. Because no matter how much they hate this country has more freedoms and more benefits and more, well, luxurious lifestyles for even the most incapable idiots on the planet. You make it to the U.S., you're pretty much taken care of one way or another if you're not a fool and you don't know how to work the system. Or you don't want to work the system because, you know, there's some people that don't want to work the system because it's a sham. And eventually you're going to be so bought into the system, you're going to be so stuck on it that you can't get out of it. And that's when they got you. It's like a mouse with a little piece of cheese, right? Feeding the cheese, and then smack, come down on you. You don't believe me, people don't believe me, that's all right. That's how it goes. You have to just wait for the people to experience it and then go, oh, that dude was right. And they probably won't even remember who told them that. Because there's many people out there warning you. But, you know, those are conspiracy theorists. Well, we don't do any conspiracy theorizing here. We might do some theory crafting. You know, just engage. Okay, let's see what possibly could happen. We're not telling you it is happening, like aliens at Area 51 or something. No. Man, I'm fired up these shows. I love these half-hour shows. They zoom along. I get to just unleash. And as you can tell, folks, I know my stuff. That's all you got to do is kind of read up on the stuff a little bit and go, okay, here's what the malpractice media is telling you. Here's what you got to look out for. That's it for the show. Thank you for joining us. We'll see you again on Monday tomorrow. For those of you in River Rouge, Michigan, who don't know what tomorrow is or who don't know what Monday is, we'll see you then, and we'll be right, well, happy and joyful. I don't know what's going to happen, but we'll tell you what's going on. Right here on the John LeBanc Show, signing out for now.
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We have liftoff. Tune in again next week. Same time, same space, same station.
Resistance is futile.